Good morning and welcome to our service of Holy Communion today. Today we celebrate Bible Sunday, and it is a great day to delve into these wonderful scriptures that are both a guide and a help to us in life. So as we stand, let us, if you would like, use your hymn books. That's hymn 509. Let us sing, "Rise and Hear, the Lord is Speaking." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
So let's say our prayer of preparation together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's two commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So we now sing the Gloria from our service booklet, which is on page 4.
Glory.
scriptures to be written for our learning. Help us soon to hear them, to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that through patience and the comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and ever hold fast the hope of everlasting life which you have given us in our Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. So please now be seated for our readings.
Old Testament reading is taken from Isaiah 55, beginning at the first verse, an invitation to abundant life. Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters, and you that have no money, come buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk, without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labour for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourself in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen, so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that you do not know shall run to you, because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to be empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Childhood, you have known the sacred writings that are able to instruct you for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that everyone who belongs to God may be proficient, equipped for every good work. In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who is to judge the living and the dead, and in view of his appearing and his kingdom, I solemnly urge you, proclaim the message, be persistent whether the time is favourable or unfavourable, convince, rebuke, and encourage with the utmost patience and teaching.
For the time is coming when people will not put up with sound doctrine, but having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit their own desires, and will turn away from listening to the truth and wander away to myths. As for you, always be sober, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, carry out your ministry fully. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We now stand to sing the hymn 373 in your booklets. Help us, O Lord, to learn the truth thy word imparts. Let's stand to sing. Into the Bible, I would sincerely hope you had studied started, some of you who have been churchgoers for many years. But if you have, you know that the Bible is like a TARDIS. It's bigger on the inside. There's much more within it than you would even think. And so this is quite a phenomenal drawing, really, because that's just the New Testament on the front there. And so the Bible is quite a complicated document, isn't it? And I was reading this book. This book is called Music at Midnight, The Life and Poetry of George Herbert. But actually within it, it talks about how he thought of the Bible. And I think it's cracking, so I'm going to share it with you. For him, the Bible is not so much a book in the ordinary sense of the word as a library, a collection of books held together with a span from the beginning of its history to its end. Within that span, there are narratives, including myths, legends, chronicles, and novels, books of proverbs and pragmatic philosophy, prophecies and poems, secular as well as sacred, legal codes and letters. There are also various and contradictory views of events and their meanings. There is much dispute in this book. The Psalms argue with God, his providence and his absence. The books of Job and Ecclesiastes subject such consensus as there is to radically sceptical critique. And these were particular favourites of George Herbert in his darker moods. There's something for everyone. For the Christian reader, like George Herbert, it all held together in Jesus. But even there, in the New Testament, versions of Jesus are banded in four different Gospels and the imagery of the epistles. But for Herbert, this variety was not a problem to be solved by theological or historical critical exertions, but a store of wonders and delights for everyday use. At all events, Herbert was more devoted to the Bible as a resource, a guide to life, and a mirror of his human self rather than an authority, which, being a churchman, he took for granted. George Herbert wrote two sonnets on the Holy Scriptures. The first is deliciously medicinal, launching off from the dangerously artless double stress of, oh, book! Then hopping along the light feet through plentiful broken lines which continue the sense throughout. And what I will say to you, there's two words here that you might not know. One is a lydia, and a lydia is an ambassador. And the other word is a hand cell. And that is a New Year's present to wish good luck. Okay, this is his first sonnet. Oh, book, infinite sweetness, let my heart suck every letter and a honey gain. Precious for any grief in any part, to clear the breast, to mollify all pain. Thou art all health, health thriving till it make a full eternity. Thou art a mass of strange delights, which we may wish and take. Interestingly, ladies, look here. This is the thankful glass that mends the looker's eyes. It is the well that washes what it shows. Who can endear thy praise too much? Thou art heaven's lydia ambassador here, working against the states of death and hell. Thou art joy's handsel, New Year's Eve present. Heaven lies flat in thee, subject to every mountain's bended knee. For Herbert, the Bible is a flat map of encircling heaven. It becomes a rider's mounting block. The rider bends his knee to mount his horse. The devout reader bends their knee in prayer. The first sonnet is just, oh, book, you're pretty marvellous. The second sonnet is, what do we do with it? Seeing not only how each verse does shine, but all the constellations of the story, this verse marks that, and both do make a motion on a third that 10 leaves off doth lie. Then, as dispersed herbs do watch, they wait to contrive a potion, and these make up some Christian destiny. For in everything, thy words do find me out, and parallels bring, and in another word, make me understand. George Herbert, in the 17th century, used the Bible as a guide, as words of life that spoke to him in his daily life. He found the Bible an inspiration, a place where he could go and seek God in the scriptures. God does lift out of the scriptures. It is quite interesting, actually, how many people would rather read other books that just touch upon only minusculely what the Bible touches upon. And fair play, it is a difficult book. It's a library of all those things. So can I simply encourage you to delve into it more and more if you can. There are many ways of reading it. There's a little booklet at the Crossing, Daily Readings, that you can get into it. But also once a month, and indeed this Thursday, I'm giving a Bible study in this hall at the Educational Forum. I do a Bible study, I think, virtually every month, and we're coming into Advent, so there'll be more of it there. But do come, open your eyes, your minds, and your hearts to what shines out of the scriptures. As Georgia Herbert says, like stars. Amen. I just like the thought of the TARDIS of the Bible. So the choir will now sing, "Teach me, O Lord, the way of your statutes."
Teach me, O Lord, the
time of prayer, so do please sit or kneel as you are comfortable.
Dearly beloved Father, as the days begin to shorten and there is a definite chill in the air, we thank you for the last beautiful month, few months. We appreciate the unseasonable warmth we have experienced and get ready to prepare ourselves for the winter to come. The readings today emphasize the love of God for his people. Let us learn from these passages to all work in harmony towards our future, to put aside our petty differences and all join together in God's love to make this world a better place for everyone, rich and poor, black and white, the refugees, the homeless, the lonely and the sick. We are all God's children and he has given each of us the responsibility to care for one another and for the planet on which we live. Lord, in your mercy. In a few days' time, it will be COP26. Let us pray for all the politicians, statesmen and scientists who will be gathering together in an attempt to save this beautiful earth that you have given us to live on. Clear their hearts and minds so that they might take seriously the very real threat that faces us all. Help them to abandon their capitalistic and political interests and understand that, like the recent pandemic, this is a problem which we have all worked together to solve. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
With this in mind, I'm reading from a beautiful Jewish prayer. Along with the endangered owls and the snow leopards at risk of extinction and the dying colours of so many species of butterfly, add this, the gold-winged human soul. We have forgotten who we are. We have become estranged from the movements of the earth. We have turned our backs on the cycles of life. We have sought only our own security. We have exploited simply for our own ends. We have distorted our knowledge. We have abused our power. We ask forgiveness. We ask for the gift of remembering. We ask for the strength to change. Yet it is not too late. There is, please God, still time to learn the simple truth. One glorious chain of love, of giving and receiving, unites all creatures. None is by or for itself, but all things exist in continued reciprocal activity, one for all and all for one. Oh my God, oh my God, let these never cease. The sand and the sea, the rush of the waters, the crash of the heavens, the prayer of the human heart. Finally, let us take a few moments of quiet prayer whilst we all think about these beautiful words and the meaning behind them.
Thank you, Vicky. So now let us stand to sing hymn number 166, Lord, thy word abideth, and our footsteps guideth. Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin. He lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. And so, Father, calling to mind his death upon the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Wednesday, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. To distribute it. So. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts, by faith, with thanksgiving. Let us pray. God of all grace, your Son Jesus Christ fed the hungry with the bread of his life and the word of his kingdom. Renew your people with your heavenly grace, and in all our weakness, sustain us by your true and living bread, who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. And so let us say the post-communion prayer together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. And so let us stand to sing hymn number 431 in your hymn book or on the screen. We have a gospel to proclaim, good news for all in all the earth.
Just a quick few notices.
the booklet for All Souls Service, I will put it to the crossing. All Souls Service is next Sunday evening at 6 o'clock, when we remember those whom we love but see no longer. A very special little intimate service just around here, so that we can stop and think of those whom we still love and we miss so much. So do please look and check that your loved one's name is here. They are in alphabetical order. If it's not there, please put it in the right place so that the name will be read out. But I'll put that at the crossing. The only other message to give you is that this Wednesday we are doing the first village lunch in the Royal British Legion since well before lockdown. It is our joy to be in partnership with the Royal British Legion and the community, and we are doing this as a lovely team together. 2-course meal, £5 with refreshments afterwards, and also it will be supporting a bric-a-brac stall and a raffle for the St Mary's Friendship Trust, which is our charitable giving arm of the church. We support about 14 to 19 charities every year without fail, because we have such a great system in place. So it will be raising money for the St Mary's Friendship Trust so that we can give on your behalf to many, many charities. You do have to be on the electoral roll to nominate, the electoral roll of this church to nominate, and the closing date is next Sunday. So do go to the village lunch if you would like to support St Mary's Friendship Trust, and do add your names or check them, tick them, if they are there in readiness for our beautiful All Souls service. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and with all those whom you love, now and always. Amen.
During this difficult time when our church buildings are closed, we're still a church, meeting virtually for prayer services and fellowship, loving our neighbours by offering practical support to the vulnerable, and caring for our communities. The work of our church is reliant on people's generosity, a generosity that is a hallmark of a lived-out faith and a testament to it. We give to our church in a variety of ways, but with the closure of all our buildings, we cannot receive all the gifts that we usually would. So we really need your help now.